Three Filipinos are confirmed killed in massive flooding in the United Arab Emirates. The Migrant Workers Department said two of the victims died of suffocation inside their vehicle. The third victim died after his vehicle fell into a sinkhole at the height of the flooding. DMW assures the families of the victims of full support and assistance. The UAE received a year's worth of rain in just one day. The heavy rainfall killed 19 people in neighboring Oman. Volunteers using kayaks to help those stranded by flooding in Dubai with no power or water and no access to food. Residents admit feeling frustrated with the lack of government assistance. Some are also blaming authorities for poor planning.
Here is fully flooded. There is a building have no electricity, no water. Also, food not getting for tenant. That is why helping them.
Call Diwa, we have called municipalities, no one came. We have called police, no one came for rescue to assist us, but no one came. So we are asking Dubai government to come for rescue. All the tenants already left. Some move inside the water, some we assist them with the canoe. All of them, they are not happy. They are angry. So they need Dubai to come and help them. Actually, for them to eat, for them to take away the water, especially to take away the water.
Rains are rare in the UAE and elsewhere in the Arab Peninsula. Researchers, however, anticipate climate change will lead to a greater risk of flooding in parts of the Gulf region. The problem can be worsened in countries like the UAE, where there is a lack of drainage infrastructure to cope with heavy rains. Several lawmakers are accused by China of stoking tensions between Manila and Beijing. This follows calls to investigate the increased presence of Chinese nationals in areas hosting joint military facilities of the Philippines and the U.S.
Philippine Senator Riza Hontiveros will call for a probe into the reported presence of Chinese nationals near EDCA sites. The senator calls it a national security concern that must be addressed. The Armed Forces of the Philippines earlier said it will look into the influx of thousands of Chinese college students in the province of Cagayan. Naval Base Camilo Osias in Santa Ana, Cagayan was named as one of the four new sites for the Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement, or EDCA. But it's not just Cagayan. According to security analyst Chester Cabalza, other key strategic areas like Subic are also seeing an influx of Chinese students.
Subic is fronting the West Philippine Sea also. So it's not only exclusive in Cagayan, but I think in some of the key strategic locations in Luzon, basically. They're not our enemies. We just have a strategic problem with them in the West Philippine Sea. We have to put that into context. But at the same time, they should be transparent also in their businesses with us.
But the Chinese embassy in Manila brushes off the allegations. It slams Philippine lawmakers for their malicious claims over the influx of Chinese students in Cagayan province. The embassy says the lawmakers are hyping up maritime issues to serve their political agenda and self-interest. It said these lawmakers' supposed concerns are intended to incite suspicion and hatred against China. Cagayan Governor Manuel Mamba, for his part, asserts the Chinese students in the province entered the country legally with visas issued by the Department of Foreign Affairs.
Invitation extended to our foreign students is a program of the national government in response to our president's call for good relations with our neighbors. Ayoko po kasing mawala sila in the midst of the good relationship. They have contributed so much in our local economy.
He also said there is no concrete basis to link the presence of Chinese students to the ongoing tensions in the West Philippine Sea between Manila and Beijing.
I want to apologize because I feel that they should not be dragged in things like this unless there are complaints against them.
In a statement, Commission on Higher Education Chairman Prospero De Vera said Based on their records, there are no Chinese students in local colleges and universities in Cagayan Province, but there is a significant number of Chinese students enrolled in St. Paul University, Philippines, in Tuguegarao City. He added, SPUP has been granted autonomy by CHED. It is also authorized by the Bureau of Immigration to accept foreign students. De Vera clarified they have not received complaints regarding any violations committed by the university. He added that security concerns will have to be investigated by security agencies and they are willing to cooperate.
First Lady Liza Araneta Marcos gets candid about her strained relationship with Vice President Sara Duterte. She spoke to broadcaster Anthony Taberna on his YouTube channel. The First Lady said she was always kind to the Vice President, but she admitted she was hurt when the Vice President attended a Davao City rally and laughed when her father, former President Rodrigo Duterte, accused her husband of being a drug addict.
Kumusta kayo ni VP Sara?
I was always kind to her. When Bong had that Bagong Lipunan rally, she came and my husband, that was supposed to be December eh. Parang to start the new year, o Bagong Pilipinas, parang huwag na tayo mag-away, mabait tayo, let's help the people, blah, 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 blah. And na-postpone, ganyan. So I think it was in Feb or March, right? So she went there at 3 and then she went to
Davao.
And then when she went to Davao, Duterte said, oh, bangag, bangag, diba? Imagine a former president calling, bangag. I mean, wow, you had 6 years, why would you call, bangag, diba? For me, nasaktan ako because my husband will do everything to protect you. You ran together, diba? Sama-sama tayo, babangon muli. Pupunta ka sa rally, tatawagan yung presidente mong bangag, di ba you're going to laugh? Tama ba yan? Even Lenny never did that.
There have been speculations of a rift between the two after the First Lady seemingly ignored Vice President Duterte during a send-off ceremony last month. Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Chanel Dominguez. Good morning, Chanel.
Good morning, Bettina. Good morning to all. Here's a weather update. We're currently not monitoring any tropical cyclone or low pressure area within and outside our Philippine area of responsibility. However, the ridge of high pressure area continues to affect eastern section of Luzon. Due to this, our whole country expect a generally fair weather with the chances of localized during the afternoon and the evening. Expect a temperature range here in Metro Manila 24 to 35 degrees Celsius and a heat index today expect to be 39 degrees Celsius to 40 degrees Celsius. That's the latest here at PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. Chanel Dominguez and good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Chanel. The United States stops the United Nations from recognizing a Palestinian state by casting a veto in the Security Council to deny it full membership to the world body. Britain and Switzerland abstained, while the remaining 12 council members voted yes. The U.S. says an independent Palestinian state should be established through direct negotiations with Israel and not through U.N. action. The Palestinians are currently a non-member observer state. An application to become a full U.N. member needs to be approved by the Security Council and then at least two-thirds of the General Assembly. UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres criticizing the limited aid that continues to reach the Gaza Strip. Guterres says Israel's commitments to improving aid access in the enclave have had limited to no impact, with progress in some areas cancelled out by delays and restrictions elsewhere. He adds Israel's cooperation is required for the UN and other aid groups to fully utilize all possible routes and crossings into the Strip.
To avert imminent famine and further preventable deaths from disease, we need a quantum leap in humanitarian aid to Palestinians in Gaza. Food is essential, so are clean water, sanitation, and health care. This means addressing the challenges impeding delivery on the ground. Delivering aid at scale requires Israel's full and active facilitation of humanitarian operations including through a functioning humanitarian notification system and improved and direct communications between humanitarians and military decision makers on the ground. This is essential and must be implemented immediately.
The UN has long complained of obstacles to getting aid in and distributing it throughout Gaza during the six-month war between Israel and Hamas. The full 12-person jury in Donald Trump's historic criminal trial has been seated. The panel is composed of 7 men and 5 women. The Manhattan court is now working on selecting 6 alternates, and 1 has been picked so far. Judge Juan Merchan is hopeful the selection process will be finished when the trial resumes Friday. Outside the courtroom, Trump once again railed at Merchan, calling the trial a New York scam. Trump is accused of falsifying business records to cover up a sex scandal.
I'm supposed to be in a lot of different places campaigning, but I've been here all day on a trial that really is a very unfair trial. The whole world is watching this hoax. You got a DA that's out of control. You have a judge that's highly conflicted. The whole thing is a mess, and you have the leading candidate and leading crooked Joe Biden by a lot. He's the one that should be in trouble. We have no justice in having a press that doesn't want to cover the facts.
Meanwhile, prosecutors say Trump violated his gag order 7 more times. The order was issued to stop Trump from making statements about witnesses, jurors, prosecutors, and court staff. Judge Merchan will have a hearing on the matter next week. U.S. President Joe Biden getting the endorsement of the Kennedys during a campaign event in Philadelphia. This in rebuke of Robert F. Kennedy Jr.'s independent bid for the White House. Many in the elite family have broken with Kennedy, who is a known anti-vaccine advocate, over his views.
We want to make crystal clear our feeling that the best way forward for America is to re-elect Joe Biden and Kamala Harris to 4 more years. President Biden has been a champion for all the rights and freedoms that my father and uncle stood for. That's why nearly every single grandchild of Joe and Rose Kennedy supports Joe Biden. God bless all of you.
Biden has been campaigning in Pennsylvania this week, a critical swing state for his re-election bid.
What an incredible honor. What an incredible honor. I don't want to become emotional, but what an incredible honor to have the support of the Kennedy family. Donald Trump's vision is one of anger, hate, revenge, and retribution. He embraces the insurrectionist of January the 6th. He's running on it. And as mentioned already, he promised to be a dictator on day one, his own words. In 2024, we have a chance to make hope and history rhyme again. Are you ready to do that with me?